What is up, YouTube? Ryan back with another Minor League Monday today. As you guys just watched, Nick Madrigal for the Chicago White Sox is my pick for today's Minor League Monday. I kid you not, you guys. Last week I missed an episode because my AC went out. Just got it fixed right now, currently. Just got a phone call saying it's fixed. Fiance called me. Super happy. But this is still being recorded on my phone for this week because I don't have time to get it up otherwise. But I kid you not, Nick Madrigal was going to be my video this week, regardless. Guess what? This weekend, he got called up to the bigs, you guys. So I figure this is the perfect time to make it because it's super relevant. I know some of the minor leaguers that I'm talking about aren't going to see the field for another year. But I find it perfect that he just got called up this week, or this weekend, I should say, because it lets you guys see what he's doing and you guys can follow him along. So to start off, you guys, Nick Madrigal, I've been following him pretty hard since he was in college at Oregon State. Obviously, I'm from Arizona. I'm a big ASU guy. So Pac-12 is the division I watch the most. Watched a ton of Nick Madrigal in college. Seen him play live. Very, very scrappy player, guys. He's 5'8", 175 right now. He was drafted fourth overall in the 2018 draft. And guys, he is so scrappy. If I had to compare anybody on earth to Derek Jeter, if that's even possible, it would be Nick Madrigal. The way he just plays the game is so fun to watch. And honestly, I don't think I've ever been this excited for a singles hitter. He's never going to be a big power bat, but I think he could really scale as a player. And I think his cards could be worth value down the road. This is 100% a long-term investment guy. But he's definitely someone that needs to be on your radar. All right, you guys, so let's jump into his grades. Kind of always include this in my video. So just to start off, I already said he's 5'8", 175. So he's not a big guy. He's not a big guy at all. He is the number 4 ranked prospect in the White Sox organization and the number 39th overall. That kind of just shows how good the White Sox organization is. If he's number 39, and he's number 4 in that organization. There's 3 more ahead of him. Kind of crazy. So we'll start off with his grades. So they grade his hit a 70, power 35, arm a 40, run 60, and field 60. So he actually won a gold glove last year in the minor leagues at second base. So he's a very good second base defender. Don't have to worry about that at all. Maybe we'll see him play some shortstop every now and then to give Tim Anderson a break. Who knows? Maybe he becomes the full-time shortstop, because Tim Anderson's pretty bad at shortstop defensively. Who knows? We'll have to wait and see. So they graded him a 70 hit, guys. He's honestly, I don't know. Like, I compared him to Derek Jeter earlier. And there's just some people in this world that we've all played against, played with, that just literally can hit, and hit, and you can't explain it. And Nick Madrigal is one of those guys. The dude legit has the gene of hitting in his blood. I've never seen him not be able to succeed with a bat in his hands. It's actually nuts. He doesn't have a lot of power. He doesn't. He's going to be probably in the pros. I would expect him to be 10 home runs to maybe 15 home runs at an absolute most. I mean, maybe he'll hit 20 one year, but he can get into baseball. So like I said, similar to Derek Jeter in the way that I think they play. They're not trying to hit home runs, but sometimes they run into the ball. And I know Derek Jeter is a huge comparison, but that's just someone that I see comparing to him play style wise. So let's jump into his stats a little bit, you guys. Nick Madrigal, national championship at Oregon State. Freshman year hits 333, sophomore year 380, junior year 367, then gets drafted fourth overall. 2018 first year in minor leagues, guys. And I do apologize. I have literally notes in front of me since this is all being recorded on my phone. I usually just stare at the screen. But first year in the minors, you guys, in 2018, he played rookie ball, A ball, and high A. Over that period of time, 303 batting average, 353 on base percentage, 700 OPS. He's never going to be a huge OPS guy. I mean, I can't see him ever being really over 900. I could see him being in the 800s just because he's pretty good at getting on base. But he's never going to have those huge slugging percentage numbers unless he becomes just like a crazy doubles hitter. Maybe he does. I'm guessing not. So very good first year in the minors. Cannot argue with 300, especially transferring to a wood bat. 2019, last year, absolutely goes off, you guys. Plays at high A, and then they move him up to double A, and then triple A. And it's kind of crazy because it seemed like he did better and better every time he moved up. So he started off kind of slow in A ball. And as you guys can see, they moved him up to double A just because you're like, we're fast tracking this guy. We really think he's advanced for his age. Really didn't do great at A ball. Moved him up to double A, 341. And then they move him to triple A, guys. A lot of guys, if they move really quick through double A, they kind of can take a step back at triple A. But Nick Madrigal hit 331. He has the hitting gene. He just hits. It's crazy. Like, I've watched so much footage of this guy, and it's just, he hits the ball hard almost every time, it seems like. So I really contemplated making this video, guys, on Nick Madrigal. I really wanted to make sure he didn't get brought down. And I just totally told you guys to watch someone that didn't succeed in the majors his first time around. But his third game, he went 4-for-4. He got his first hit, and they just kept coming after that. Ended up scoring a run and getting an RBI. So he had a very good game three. I think that four-hit game definitely solidified his spot in the lineup. As long as he doesn't drop into some crazy slump now, I think he's going to be the Chicago White Sox second baseman for a long time. So now, guys, we're going to talk about his sports cards, everyone's favorite part of these videos. What I think about them, I think Nick Madrigal is a solid buy right now. I don't think he is an immediate buy now. I don't think he's an immediate sell now. I think he's a good buy, and I don't think you're going to regret it. So 2018 Bowman draft is definitely what I would focus on right now. He could be in Topps update this year. I'm definitely looking out for that, and if he is, sell me all of his cards. I think in Topps update, you could find his cards for very cheap, probably between $1 and $5, I'm guessing. So keep an eye out for Topps update. But for now, his best cards are 2018 Bowman draft. The base cards right now you can find between probably $2 and $10, I'd say. And I'd say if you can get any under $5 is like a buy for sure. And then his refractors, again, these are non-autoed base and refractor. His refractors, They've gone up in price. They're selling between $10 and $20, I'd say. Just depends how lucky you get, I guess. So I think it's a little high, but again, it's not the worst in the world. Obviously, you guys know my obsession with refractors. I absolutely love them. I would buy those first if you can find a good deal. So then let's talk about the autos, guys. And I'm just going to talk about the base auto because the Bowman autos get expensive. And I do think they're all fairly priced. So right now the base auto is selling between $60 and $100. I think it's solid. Like, I don't think it's a bad buy. I don't think it's a good buy. Like, it's in the middle for me. Like, $60 to $100 is like the middleman for me. Like, I don't think you're going to regret it, but it's obviously still not like a low risk buy. Like, if you're like me, you're on a budget, like $60 is a lot of money to spend on one card, especially if it's someone that we don't know how good they're going to be. So for me, it's in the middle. I already have one of these, thankfully, so I don't have to buy one, but again, I probably would buy one and not be upset with myself. I think he's a good buy. I think he's going to be a really good player in the future. So when we talk about his cards, guys, I think he's right in the middle. Whatever you feel, I would say if you're with me, you're a believer, then buy. Like, you're not going to be upset with yourself, I don't think. And if you're on the other side of things, like, man, he's a singles hitter, never going to have a lot of home runs, I completely understand that too. Again, this is a long-term investment. I think this is a guy that could have 2,000, 3,000 hits in the future to where his cards, they just go up because of how good of a career he has. So we'll see where that takes us. But really look for Topps update this year, guys. I'm going to hoard Nick Madrigal Topps update rookies if he's in it. If not, we'll wait till next year. Whenever his first Topps rookie card comes out, I'm going to be hoarding it. And you always have a buyer in me. All right, guys. Well, that concludes another Minor League Monday today. Again, this is all filmed on my phone, and I still have to put it all together. I hope it ends up turning out okay. Please let me know how I did in the comments. But also, guys, in the comment section, let me know what you guys think of Nick Madrigal. Do you think he's a real deal? As always, you think I'm insane for recommending him? Like, that's some of my favorite comments when people tell me I'm insane. Like, when I recommended Joey Gallo last month, people told me I was an absolute idiot. And I was like, you know, that's fair. Like, I'm cool with that. So let me know if I'm stupid. That's going to be it for today's video, guys. As always, if you like my videos, want me to keep doing Minor League Monday, please give my video a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel. I'll catch you guys next time. And you guys have a great rest of your day. See ya.